Hey guys, how's it going? Today's video is going to be a tag video started by Mary from Lumi Level Up. She's also a fellow luxury YouTuber, so if you're interested in all things luxury, go ahead and check out her channel. So the tag is bag flag tag. So we're supposed to be talking about our favorite luxury handbags in the colors of the flags of our country. I live in Australia, so my colors will be blue, red, and white. Starting first with the color red. Now, I have a few red handbags, but I will be showing you two. One will be from a modern designer and the other one will be from a premium luxury designer. I'm going to start first with the modern designer, and it is this bag over here. So this bag is by Tory Burch, and it is the Amanda Messenger bag. She was totally trendy when I got her in 2013. Back then I was using long wallets, so this was the perfect size for my basic essentials. And it comes in this lobster red and the beautiful Tory Burch logo in gold in front. There is a really handy back pocket where I used to slip my phone in, and it's got a magnetic closure. It's a fold over bag, so it opens like that. And then there's another compartment that's quite deep on the inside. So it was really quite a secure bag. I still have some mitts inside. The inside is lined with fabric. It also has a long shoulder strap, which is detachable and also adjustable in length. However, I did think that it was too long anyway. I did have to have some extra holes punched by a leather specialist. And these lobster clasps are really quite a nice feature because they do pivot. So it means that if the bag twists, these clasps will just twist along with it. The bag is still in really good nick given how much I have used this, because this was my everyday bag outside of work, and the leather is really beautiful and buttery. And one day when messenger bags come back in style, I will be rocking this bag all over again. And then the other red bag from a premium designer. This is one of my favorite bags in my whole collection, and here she is. Oh, she's so beautiful. She is the Lady Dior in small. It is in cherry red patent canage calfskin with a champagne gold hardware. So she really doesn't need much description. So obviously it's a double top handle bag. It's got this beautiful Dior charms, and it has a flap opening like so. There we go. Just got the strap inside. I'm gonna take the strap out so you can have a look. And there she is. She's one big compartment on the inside. There is a slip pocket on one side and a zippered pocket on the other. I purchased this bag in 2020, right before the pandemic hit. Now, I've wanted this bag for about 5 years, but I never bought her because the original Lady Dior design came with a zippered closure rather than a flap closure. And that was because this bag was designed for Princess Diana. So she needed the bag to be really, really secure and to make sure that the paparazzi couldn't see the inside of her bag when she had it open. But that was really too secure for me. And I did not appreciate getting my cuticle scratched every time I put my hands into the bag. So that bag was not for me. And I think Dior came up with this flap design in about 2019. And when I saw this design, I was like, Dior heard me. This bag was made for me. And I went and bought it as soon as I had the opportunity. I mean, this red as well is so irresistible, isn't it? I mean, it looks like lip gloss. So I mainly use this bag for evening events. I do prefer just carrying her by the top handle. Although she comes with a long shoulder strap, I don't really like how the bag looks with the long shoulder strap dangling at the bottom. So I prefer to keep it detached. The bag is not that comfortable to carry crossbody anyway, because when it is leaning against your body, these rings do dig in a little bit, so they're not particularly comfortable. I mean, it might be fine over a thick winter's coat, but not very comfortable in summer when you're wearing it over thin clothing. By the way, if you're new to my channel, warmest welcome. This is a lifestyle channel where I talk about a few topics. This video is part of my fashion series where I talk about luxury handbags as well as mindful shopping. If you are a parent with really young children and you like hearing all about parenting tips and hacks, I also have this series of videos over here, and I'll link to it up here. I also have a bilingual series of English-Chinese videos for children. So if you're looking for a really fun resource for your children to learn some simple Chinese, go ahead and check out this series over here, and I'll link to it above. If you're interested in any of this content, feel free to subscribe, because it would really be encouraging to me and keep me going. Moving on to white bags. I don't have a lot of white bags because they're impractical. I do have one to show you, but I think this may stir some of you. I decided to show her to you anyway because there's a really good story behind it. And here she is. So this is a Birkin inspired bag. It is not a replica because there are no logos anywhere. Nowhere on this bag does it say that this is Hermes. So this is a Birkin inspired bag. So why do I own this bag? Okay, so I bought this bag because I really needed to know whether I was going to get a Birkin 25 or not. Because I'm a very petite person, I'm only 5'1" or 152 centimeters. I'm all for small bags. I would never get the Birkin 30 because it's too big for me and it's too heavy. So my heart really wants a Birkin 25, but my brain's like, no. Oh my gosh, you should just get it, right? You love the bag. You love the bag. It's a great investment, and if you change your mind about it, you can then decide to sell it on. Or, because it's such a classic bag, you can keep it for your daughter. Whoa, just hold your horses. The bag is really, really, really expensive. And you have to build up a purchase history with the luxury house, and even then there's no guarantee that they're gonna offer you a bag that you want. Even if you decide to go pre-loved, you have to go and hunt the bag down. That's a lot of time and effort. Even then, remember, you are a top handle, shoulder strap, crossbody kind of girl, and the Birkin 25 does not have a crossbody strap. And you also really dislike handheld bags. And you don't know whether the Birkin 25 will fit on the crook of your arm because that handle drop is so small. Just listen to me. I am your brain. So I compromised $120 Australian to buy this Birkin 25 inspired bag. Since there's so many videos on the Birkin 25 out there, I was able to compare the dimensions of this bag to a genuine Birkin 25, and the dimensions are actually pretty spot on. The only difference is that this bag weighs a little bit heavier than a Birkin 25 in Togo leather. And if you're curious where I got the information regarding the Birkin 25, I watched Kat L's video on her latest Birkin 25. And then the $1 million question of whether this bag fits on the crook of my arm. It does. That's the advantage of being a small person, I guess. So yes, at this point, I am still leaning towards a Birkin 25. However, I am still practicing with this bag to see if I can tolerate carrying this for at least half a day on the crook of my arm without getting irritated by it before I actually bite the bullet. Feel free to leave me a comment, but please be kind. Moving on to the color blue. So this is my favorite blue bag in my collection because I do have a few blue bags. This is the Gucci Micro Guccissima Mini Dome bag from many, many seasons ago. It has a beautiful GG logo embossed into the leather. She is so, so nice. And also a very classic silhouette, undoubtedly inspired by the Louis Vuitton Elma BB. There is these two top handles, and there's a double zipper pull as well. She also comes with a detachable long shoulder strap, and the inside of the bag is lined with fabric or linen. There are a couple of stains at the bottom of the bag that I've never noticed before, but anyway, there they are. She's a really good medium capacity bag, and I've used her a lot for travel. When I purchased her, I was using a full-size wallet, and she does fit a full long wallet. During times where I needed to access her really frequently, I was able to leave her unzipped and my stuff would still be pretty secure in there. So those are all my bags for my bag flag tag video. I hope you enjoyed it, and certainly leave me a like if you did, because it would really help out the video and the channel. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. I'm Denny O, and I hope to see you in one of my other videos. Bye!